In 1924, the world was introduced to the Andromeda Galaxy, defying the belief that the Milky Way is the only gigantic galaxy spiraling in the enormous universe. This discovery excited astronomers and triggered the pursuit of new galaxies, prompting that we might not be alone. With every passing decade, gigantic telescopes like Hubble and James Webb were created to hunt extraterrestrial galaxies. Ever since the Webb telescope was launched, it has been making headlines for eyeing thousands of colossal galaxies. Now, shocking new findings have been made by the James Webb telescope that could change everything we know and force us to sit up and reassess all our cosmological theories. Groundbreaking discoveries that could change everything.
Orbit beyond the blue.
Continuing on its streak of making discoveries that question the Big Bang, the James Webb Space Telescope has found the most distant galaxy cluster ever seen, at 30 billion light years away. Researchers say it's probably one of the biggest clusters in the universe by now. All seven galaxies in the clump had been observed before with the Hubble Space Telescope, but scientists didn't know how far away they were or whether they were truly bound together. Because light takes time to travel from distant objects to Webb's position orbiting the Sun, the telescope sees these galaxies as they were about 650 million years after the Big Bang. As we currently see the protocluster, it appears small. But if its light could reach us instantaneously, letting us see what it looks like today, it is very likely it would be colossal, having gravitationally roped in thousands of other galaxies. The researchers' simulations hint that this protocluster may now be one of the most enormous clusters in the universe. Recently, the James Webb Telescope also discovered a minuscule galaxy, 13 billion years in the past, that has given rise to new stars at an exceptionally high rate for its tiny size. It is said to be the smallest galaxy ever discovered at this distance. In a groundbreaking discovery, a team of researchers from the University of Minnesota used the James Webb Telescope to peek into more than 13 billion years into the past to discover an extraordinary tiny galaxy that has generated stars at an extreme rate for its size. This tiny galaxy is one of the smallest ever discovered at this distance, around 500 million years after the Big Bang. If this doesn't excite you enough, then you should know that this tiny galaxy could potentially help astronomers to understand more about the galaxies that were present millions of years ago just after the universe burst into existence. This galaxy is far beyond the reach of all telescopes except the James Webb. And these first-of-their-kind observations of the distant galaxy are spectacular, said Patrick Kelly, senior author of this paper. The galaxy is roughly a millionth in the volume of the Milky Way, but interestingly it is still forming the same number of stars every year. That is insane. If you wonder how the James Webb Telescope can observe such tiny details in a wide enough field to capture the entire galaxy cluster at once, it is mainly because of a phenomenon called gravitational lensing. Gravitational lensing uses lenses that bend and magnify the light of the mass present in the galaxy or galaxy cluster. Thanks to gravitational lensing, this tiny galaxy appeared 20 times brighter than it would have appeared. Mind you, this is apparently the first time it was possible to look into most of the way back to the Big Bang, and James Webb Telescope, with its galaxy hunting abilities, has made it look easier than ever before. In July 2022, astronomers found Galaxy 13, which was the frontrunner to be the oldest galaxy in the observable universe. But a new candidate entered the chat, and it was so far away that it could break the models of our universe. In a preprint paper released in August 2022, Rowan Naidu, an astrophysicist based at Harvard's and Smithsonian's jointly operated Center for Astrophysics, has detailed another distant galaxy candidate from one of Webb Telescope's early release science programs, known as CERS-1749. It's an extremely bright galaxy that, if confirmed, would have existed just 220 million years after the Big Bang, and it could also rewrite our understanding of the cosmos. But there was a bloody huge catch. CERS-1749 could be one of the most distant galaxies we've ever seen, or it could be lurking much closer to home. Essentially, the data seemed to indicate two possible places for the galaxy to be, and we wouldn't know which one is correct without a lot more observation. That's how it earned the title of Schrödinger's galaxy candidate. How can a galaxy like Schrödinger seem to be in two different places? Well, it's all about redshift. To determine how far away a galaxy lies, astronomers study wavelengths of light. Specifically, they are interested in a phenomenon of light known as redshift. In a nutshell, light waves leaving distant galaxies get stretched over time, shifting the waves down the electromagnetic spectrum and making them more, well, red. So, ultraviolet light leaving a galaxy like Schrödinger won't reach Earth as ultraviolet light. Instead, it will be redshifted down into the infrared, which is great for us because that's just the kind of light Webb searches for. And Webb has various filters, looking at distinct wavelengths of infrared. In examining a galaxy like Schrödinger, you can flick through the wavelengths like you might flick through a photo album. On the first few pages, few red wavelengths, you won't see a thing. Then, as you turn through and the wavelengths become more red, the ghost of a galaxy appears. In the most redshifted wavelengths, at the back of the album, the galaxy is a clearly defined object. This would also mean we might need to rethink our models of how galaxies evolved in the earliest days of the universe. Galaxies from that long ago should not be this bright, at least according to the model we currently use to explain our cosmos. But maybe we don't need to break physics just yet. It might be that Schrödinger is actually a satellite galaxy of one of its more massive neighbors, and it could be much closer to us. Another group of researchers also studied this exact same galaxy from the early release data, on the same day. Jorge Zavala, an astrophysicist at ALMA Japan, and his team, added to the JWST data, with data from an Earth-based telescopes in the French Alps and Hawaii. They came to the conclusion that Schrödinger might be an imposter, masquerading as a high redshift galaxy, when it's actually a much closer, dusty galaxy undergoing rapid star formation. Scientists found themselves in a bind, since the data suggested two potential locations for Schrödinger, and no one was yet certain which one was accurate because further investigation and observation were still needed. In particular, spectroscopy will allow astrophysicists to scrutinize its redshift more accurately. The only barrier now was time, getting enough time on telescopes around the world to study Schrödinger and solve the puzzle. But hold on, Schrödinger was only a part of the massive image released by Webb. The images indicated that massive galaxies were already forming in the earliest days of the epoch of reionization, when the plasma that evenly filled the early universe collapsed into more familiar stars and galaxies. Despite its tremendous size and all the ancient galaxies contained within it, the image was just a tiny slice of the sky. Atmospheres of exoplanets that lie in the habitable zone of their stars, artificial lights around exoplanets, and study of the moons of Jupiter and Saturn are only a few of the several investigations the super powerful telescope will run. Speaking of exoplanets, Webb clicked the very first image of an exoplanet. Astronomers revealed the first photograph of an exoplanet taken by NASA's James Webb Space Telescope. The image showed the bright blob of a world seven times heavier than Jupiter, that orbits a star nearly 400 light-years away. The groundbreaking result was the latest in a slew of early exoplanet findings from the telescope, and a test of technologies that will enable direct imaging of Earth-like planets by future space telescopes. It's exhilarating, to say the least. To photograph the hot, young giant, HIP-65-426b, JWST blocked the light of its host star using a small mask known as a coronagraph. This revealed the orbiting planet, which was thousands of times fainter, like a firefly around a searchlight. HIP-65-426b orbited about 100 times farther from its star than Earth does the Sun, taking 630 years to complete an orbit. This distance meant it's easier to see the planet against the glare of the star, that coupled with the planet's extreme heat and brightness, it had a scorching temperature of about 900 degrees Celsius, a fever left over from its formation just 40 million years ago, which made it a prime target for direct imaging. HIP-65-426b's surface features weren't visible in the image, but Biller said it would probably look banded like Jupiter, with belts caused by variations in temperature and composition, and might have spots in its atmosphere caused by storms or vortices. The giant planet was inhospitable to life as we knew it, but it represented a class of large planets that scientists are eager to learn more about. Every week, we wait with bated breath for Webb to show us our cosmos like never seen before. And surely, with more discoveries, more challenges to the existing model of the universe will come forward. After all, what is science if not questioning and rethinking everything we know? But what do I know?
Orbit. Beyond the blue.